without you. Maybe I'm not lost forever, out in the dark. The storm is over, you made it stop. I've come to find you're what I want. So I laugh about it, my tears are dry. No doubt about it, I'll be alright. My past behind me, I'm letting go. And all that I know, it's gonna be better. It's gonna be better. As long as we're together, it's gonna be better. It's gonna be better now. It's gonna be better now. As long as we're together, it's gonna be better. It's gonna be better now. I see the future, it's looking bright. I'm falling to you like paradise. The world looks different behind your eyes. What I was missing is here tonight. So I laugh about it, my tears are dry. No doubt about it, I'll be alright. My past behind me, I'm letting go. And all that I know, it's gonna be better. It's gonna be better. As long as we're together,
oh,
it's gonna be better.
Oh, don't mess my makeup.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
It was so beautiful.
Thanks.
Get that out again.
Wow. It was gorgeous.
Oh, God.
You look beautiful.
Thanks,
the dress is fantastic.
Thank you.
I knew everyone as soon as I saw it that day.
Yeah.
You look great.
Thanks.
It's all you.
I hope Lee cries.
Wow, nice dress. Really nice dress.
Yeah, beautiful.
Really nice. Come on. I know. Come here.
Don't fuck up right now. All right.
Guys, it's a pretty good.
Dear Melissa, I love you because you are loving, kind, and understanding. You keep me positive on the toughest days. Today will be one of the many great days in our life. I can't wait to spend it with you. I promise that every day I will try to make our future better by achieving all that you want out of life. I knew you were the one denouncing the Yankees, driving 4 hours to see the Mets play. You inspire me to be a better person, husband, brother, and son every day, and to live out my dreams with you by my side. Lovely. That was sweet.
Why you gotta be beside me? What you need, won't you be? I'm afraid.
Hospitality, and it comes so
Lee, hi, I love you. I cannot wait to see you today. Every day you've been in my life has been better than the next. You make me so happy, I can't believe it some days. I've been blessed to know you as a friend, fall in love with you, and now to marry you. Let's grow old together and birdwatch until the end of our days. Love you more than words, Melissa. Trust me, I'm starting to realize.
Hi, honey. Looking handsome.
Love the dress.
Thank you. I just walked across the street in it.
It's good.
Stop trying to make it
for our bride.
I love you. congratulations, here you are. Happy wedding day. Thanks for bringing us here. Everyone's now they can all say they've been to a Botello wedding, which is really special, really special. Yeah, it's great. The people here are beautiful, and the food is wonderful. Everyone's in for a really, really lovely time. So some couples get so nervous that they don't remember their ceremony ever happening. So I don't want that to happen to you, right? So we're going to start with a big deep breath. Lovely, right? Mindfulness. And then you need to turn and get a round of applause for how astonishingly how astonishingly beautiful you look on your wedding day. Most brides do that with great reluctance, but not you. That was awesome. That was awesome. So here you are. 2018, was it? When did we meet? 2018, 2019, right on the cusp. Mm-hmm. Friends first,
yes.
Right? He used to hang around the apartment. Yeah, and then I loved how, you know how you describe, I don't know if you remember this, but in the diner you described it to me as your favorite roommate of all time. So that's really nice. But friends first, right?
Right.
Yeah. Hung around, right? Got massages or something like that. Not from her. Now, well, hopefully eventually from her. But I loved the pretext for him coming over. It was very sweet. Yeah, and then you turned into something. And now here you are, to be so certain. It's really fun to be around the two of you because you know you have found someone absolutely beautiful, you know, who's going to make you raise your game,
right.
You know, and become a better person than you are because you admire each other so much you want to kind of live up to the other one's level. That's the proper way to do it. The two of you are really impressive. You know, no, to be kind and to be good and to know who you are, to know how to spend your time, you know, to make other people's lives easier. To have two jobs that you love, how lucky are you? Blessed. The statistics on loving your job is not great in America, but I know you love yours, and you love the people who you work for, and you feel like you're valued. And then, they're here. I had no idea. I had no idea. He ruined one of my jokes before the wedding. No. And then everyone, does everyone know NYFD, right? FDNY, a firefighter, everyone, right? A round of applause for someone. Such an honorable profession. It's a beautiful, you know, way to live a life, you know. And a job that also brings great, great happiness because you have purpose and you have meaning, you know, and you're doing the right thing all the time. So I congratulate the two of you and your parents. You know, when you bring somebody beautiful into your life, it's a great gift to your parents because they can relax. You know, you can only be as happy as your least happy child. And you're not allowed to look at your siblings now. Just, no. what your two parents know is that wherever you are in the world, you're taking care of each other. So they can, all their hard work, they can relax and enjoy. So it's great. So I found something which I love. And I thought we'd start off your wedding this way. Get everybody into the spirit, you know, into the wedding mood. And it describes the two of you well. So listen to this. I love you, not only for what you are, but for what I am when I'm with you. I love you not only for what you've made of yourself, but for what you're making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out, for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the foolish weak things that you can't help dimly seeing there, and for drawing out into the light all the beautiful belongings that no one else had ever looked quite far enough to find. I love you because you've done more than any creed could have done to make me good, and more than any fate could have done to make me happy. There you go. Isn't that wonderful? You know, to have someone who lifts your spirits. You know, someone who makes you want to be the very best version of yourself so that you can deserve who they are. You know, and now the two of you, you know, I love being at your sister's house the other day because it's all about family, you know, for both of you. She has this wonderful, welcoming home, you know, and she's just carrying on the tradition of your parents. You know, and the two of you, I know when we talk, you want to do the same thing. You know, to have people over, you know, to cook for them and make them laugh and make them have a great time and keep the family going. It's beautiful. There's no better couple than the two of you. So all cultures around the world have the beautiful tradition of beginning a celebration by pausing to give thanks. You know, there's no happiness without gratitude. So let's ask God to bless the two of you. For Lee and Melissa, may God's love keep you safe. May you continue to grow as a couple. May you have strength against adversity and give strength to others by your love. And may you continue to build this family and this life of goodness and patience. And may you look back on today as a day full of love and laughter and hope. May God's blessings shine down upon the two of you and Shay. Today, that's what a family's all about. Today and every day of your lives together, we ask this in the name of our Lord. Amen. I love the way you describe Shay. Practice, right? Practice for something bigger in the future. You know, can we keep something alive? It's good. And now you've completely fallen. You're besotted, the two of you. How wonderful to love something else. Yeah, well, that's okay. Yeah. So it's very easy to get married. You just have to say promises to each other. And I have them in my book, okay? So just no matter what I ask you, say yes. And you'll be married at the end. Those of you who have cameras, this is Victoria down the middle. And then Alex and Douglas and Chris. But those of you who have cameras discreetly, you can take some photos now, okay? And in my experience, you should try to take as many now as you can from all the ceremonies I've done. What I've noticed is as soon as the bride and groom say, I do, their hair turns gray. So this is really it right here. New Jersey asks me to give you some wedding advice. You're fine, the two of you. You don't need very much, but I'll try. I'll try to give you a little piece of advice. And if you like it, you can hold on to it. And if you don't like it, just remember your vows. So I think when we met, I told you that I have three daughters and I officiated all their weddings. But years before, when my little girls became teenagers, I thought the most important thing was a peaceful house. You know, I wanted to end my childhood relationship with them and start my adult relationship with them, which, as your parents will tell you, is just wonderful. So when they were teenagers and they did something wrong, I didn't tell them because I didn't want to start a fight. But I realized over time that wasn't the right thing to do. Because if someone does something to hurt us, even if we pretend it doesn't hurt, the pain stays in our hearts. And for a couple, over time, that pain can build up and build up and build up and damage you. So Melissa, on your wedding day, here's my advice for you. In your mind, you have to build a little shelf with Lee's name on it. And you have to promise him that every day you're going to check the shelf to make sure it's clean. To make sure there's nothing up there that you two need to talk about. And you, sir, have to build a shelf in your mind with your wife's name. But it's not her job to clean your shelf because she can't see it. You're the only one who knows if something has come between you. The opposite of love isn't hate like we think. The opposite of love is indifference when we give up on each other and we lose hope. And nobody knows why some couples last and some don't. But one reason can be is that we've let so many things build up on our shelf that we're never arguing about today's fight. We're always arguing about all the fights from the past that we should have fixed when they happened. We thought we were being kind by saying, I won't say anything. So they keep coming up over and over and over. And if we're not careful, our shelves can get so full that we can't clean them anymore. You know, because everything's old and in the back and we don't remember the fights, but all the pain's in our hearts, you know. But if you can keep yourselves clean, 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 and every time you look at each other, it'll be like it was back in the day. And you can be happy forever. Okay, good. Yeah, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
ready.
You're still single. You can run. Huh? No? He headed for the river, if you know.
Got
his wetsuit. So first the groom says his vows, and then the bride says her vows. So you can just repeat after me. Look deeply into her eyes.
I, Lee, take you, Melissa, to be my wife. I promise I always try to be the husband you deserve. I will show my appreciation that you chose me over all others. I will care about your happiness like it is mine. I will keep our home a warm and peaceful place. I will always hold your heart gently in my hand. Today I join my life and my family to yours.
Nothing better than vows with a Staten Island accent. Fantastic.
Good. Good. I, Melissa, take you, Lee, to be my husband, my partner, my friend, loving all the things I know about you, and trusting those little things I might not know. I want to grow old with you. Getting to know the man you will become. And falling in love with you a little bit more every day. I promise to love you and take care of you through all of the joy and any of the sorrow life brings to us. Today I join my life and my family to yours.
Well done. Well done. Rings. Daniel, you have a ring for the bride. You're supposed to be 8 years old, but do the best you can. Good. There you go. So as you place the ring on her finger, say to her,
with this ring,
I marry you.
I marry you.
With all that I have.
With all that I have.
And all that I am.
Beautiful. No, you're good. Erica, a ring for your brother-in-law. Lovely. So his left hand, there you go.
With this ring, I marry you with all that I have and all that I am.
Beautiful. Everybody wants what you two have. You know? You should. No, the idea that you have found your one. Someone to build a family with. You know? Everyone looks for to have the tranquility that the two of you have. You know, this the peacefulness and the certainty is beautiful. And I don't see it in every couple that I meet. And I see it in you two. And it's really fun to be around. And you're a little different from each other. You know, so one of the things about love is to let love change you, let love you make you a different person than you were, you know, and then to see the world through somebody else's eyes. It's so beautiful, you know, because when problems come up, you get to tell each other, no, this is mine, you know, because you do not have the skills for this, but I do, you know, and I see the two of you doing it all the time. It's wonderful. It's wonderful. I read a book not long ago written by a nurse who spent her whole life in hospice. She took care of people as they were dying. And what she loved to do every night before she went home, she would visit a different patient and say, you know, tell me about your life. And since they knew that their days were drawing to an end, invariably they would talk to her, you know, if I had a chance to do it twice, this is what I would do different. So at the end of 30 years, she wrote a book about all the things that people told her if they had a second shot, how they would do things differently. And a lot of it's what the two of you do well. You know, I would spend more time with my family and friends. I would travel more. You know, the big regret that people have is not traveling. You know, I would work less. You know, but there were two that were beautiful. One was when I look back in my life, I wish I'd let myself be happier than I was. I was always pushing happiness off. I'll be happy on Friday. I'll be happy when we get the house. I'll be happy when we have kids. But that's no way to live, because whenever you get those things, more problems come. So the idea is to remind yourselves how fortunate, as you said, how grateful, how blessed to be happy now. And then the big one is when I look back in my life, I wish I had lived a life more true to myself rather than the life that other people wanted me to live, you know? The biggest regret that people have is I never became the person I was meant to be, because when I came to the crossroads, there was an easy way and a hard way, and I took the easy way. But the two of you have always taken the slightly harder path, so keep doing it. And now that you're not alone, you have somebody to grab your hand and say, let's do it together. Yeah, so wonderful. So everyone, there's a wonderful tradition in the Jewish faith that at the end of a wedding ceremony, we break a glass, and here it is. And the idea is that glass is so beautiful, it's strong, and we see the world through it. We see Manhattan now because of it, but it's also a little delicate. So the idea behind the glass is treat each other as if you're holding a piece of glass, you know, kindly, because there's things you can say that perhaps you can't recover from, you know, that you can hurt each other. You know, so always be gentle in your words and in your actions. So I'm going to put this on the ground, and then after I declare you married, the groom is going to stomp on it with his right foot. If you want to get the tallet, yeah, the tallet is right on this little table. Danny, right, there you go. The tallet is the shawl that a groom wears at his wedding. I love this beautiful tradition. You drape it across his shoulders. And everyone, when the groom breaks the glass with his right foot, we all yell, Mazel Tov, which is much, much, much happiness. So, a little poem.
I respire.
Okay. This poem talks about when you find someone who loves your perfection, but who thinks your imperfections are silly, how you can be yourself and how free you can be. Listen to this. To love is not to possess, to own or imprison, nor to lose oneself in another. Love is to join and separate, to walk alone and together, to find a laughing freedom that lonely isolation does not permit. It is finally to be able to be who we really are. And by the power vested in me, by the great state of New Jersey, I now so happily pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Good job there. Watch out. Out of the way.
I was waiting for that.
Big round of applause, everybody. Everyone, the groom's parents that the bride and groom lived with, and they still came to their wedding. Congratulations. Thank you all so very, very, very much. The alcohol is straight through the double doors. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Steve. We'll see you all inside, everyone. Thank you.
Mr. DJ, on your command.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the beautiful Botello. I asked you before, I'm gonna ask you one more time. How y'all feeling tonight? What I want everybody to do is clap your hands to the beat of the music. Come on, clap those hands. Now, if you don't know who I am already, I am the best man. I am the older brother and the new brother-in-law. So before we do, ladies and gentlemen, in the past, they were simply known as Lee and Melissa. But for the first time here tonight, make some noise for the new Mr. and Mrs. Megaman! Ladies and gentlemen, clap those hands! That's right! Melissa Lee, welcome to your party! Doesn't our bride look beautiful tonight? Doesn't she look gorgeous? And how about that handsome groom? That's right, one more time, everybody! Clap your hands for the bride and groom! And right now, as you've done already, Lee, grab your beautiful bride. Bring her right to the center of the dance floor. To ladies and gentlemen, to start our festivities off this evening, their first dance as husband and wife.
You could bet that, never gotta sweat that. You could bet that, never gotta sweat that. You could bet that, never gotta sweat that.
If you beat a charge, I beat a rubber band. You beat a match, I will be a fuse. Boom, painter, baby, you could be the muse. I'm the reporter, baby, you could be the news. Cause you're the cigarette, and I'm the smoker. We raise the bet, cause you're the joker. Chipped off, you are the chore. And I could be the blackboard, you can be the top.
Come on, give it up for the bride and groom.
Yeah, when the sky comes falling, even when the sun don't shine, I got faith in you and I.
Gotta sweat
could bet that, never gotta sweat that. You could bet that, never gotta sweat that. You could bet that, never gotta sweat that.
Be the fire, babe. If I'm the blunt, you could be the lighter, babe. Fire it up, writer, baby. You could be the quote. If I'm the lyric, baby, you could be the note. Chord that saint, I'm a sinner. Prize, I'm a winner, and it's you. What did I do to deserve that paper, baby? I'd be the pen. Say I am the one, 'cause you are ten. Feeling up to
even when the sky can fall.
That's right, guys. One more time. I'm going to touch this round of applause for the bride and groom on their first dance as husband and wife. That's right. Lee and Melissa out there. So right now, where is Dad, our father of the bride? Where's Don? Don, come on out here. Come on, Don. Don. Ladies and gentlemen, to start our parent dances this evening. How about making some noise for our bride and her dad?
Some remain, all these places have their moments. We're lovers and friends, I still can recall. Some are dead and some are living. But in my life, I've loved them all. Of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I will often stop and think about them. But in my life, I love you more.
That's right, y'all. Give it up for Melissa and her dad out there on their fabulous father-daughter dance. And right now, we ask our groom, Lee, come on up. And I want you to find the first person that loved you ever in life. And that's his mom. Give it up for the groom and his mom, everyone.
Ten lin shomotra, odrega, od ktat. Shav yaldisha, ki achshav nechman. Yeshaket, vanitra, leva. Ukshetelech, tiskot amid lishmo alatzmecha. Me anashim kashim asher omdim. במסלולך אל תפחד מעל ראשך יש מלאכים ואתה תמיד תהיה גיבור של אמא אתה תמיד תהיה לי מלך העולם תמיד עם החיוך הכי מושלם כמו בתמונות בזיכרונות כל מקום שלא תלך תהיה של אמא תמיד תהיה לי מלך העולם תמיד עם החיוך הכי מושלם כמו בתמונות בזיכרונות תמיד תהיה שלי לך ילדי לך תיזהר קח את תפילתי, את ברכתי איתך אל תשכח בני, אמא כאן בשבילך אז לך תגשים את כל חלומותיך וכשתלך תזכור תמיד לשמור על עצמך מאנשים קשים אשר עומדים במסלולך אל תפחד מעל ראשך יש מלאכים ואתה תמיד תהיה
Oh, yeah, that's right. Come on, everybody. Give it up for Lee and his first true love. It's his mom, everybody. And now that everybody's up, it's time to make your way onto the dance floor. Come on out, party people. All friends, all family. Come on out here. I want to see you guys right here, dead center, with your bride and groom. It's time to get this wedding started. Let's go, everybody. That's right. Get out your seat. Get on your feet. Melissa and Lee are in the house. Come on, come on. All my party people, where you at now? Let's go. That's right, let's go, everybody.
Everybody, hands up!
To be alive.
Ow!
Listen, I got to tell everybody this. Hold on. Listen up. You guys, if you don't know already, you know, I'm a DJ myself. I'm an MC. So to be on the other side is like mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. You know, where you want me to talk? Over here? I go left or this way? All right. So, as you guys know, I am Lee's older brother. Only brother. You know, but, he gained a brother today. Where's Pasquale? Pasquale! You know, there he is over there. Guy looking like Bentley, you know, P. Diddy's assistant. But, you know, today is about them. So Lee, he looks so handsome. You know, this bride, I can't even tell you. Melissa, gorgeous. Gorgeous. So they asked me, you know, can you write something down? I said, no, I'm not. That's just not what I do. So, Lee, we're going to start with you. My young brother. I could tell you a time when we were like, I don't know, 5 and 3. We used to wrestle. I could tell you like this. When we were kids, we used to wrestle a lot. Unfortunately, he had too much apple juice when he was a kid, so he, you know, back in the day got some dentures. And, you know, every once in a while, I'd give him a knee to the face. They would come out. That would happen, what, Mom, twice a week? Yeah, twice a week. Shit happens, you know. And then we got older. I got older. You know, I started working at, like, 13. I used to tell him about the stories at work, and we used to get drunk at, like, 14. And he said, really? I said, yeah. He said, when can I start? I said, not yet. So I could say this. I try to be the best, what's the word? Older brother, influence, you know, mentor. But I sucked. I was the bad one. He was the good one. If anybody knows him, he's a very, very mellow kind of kid. Very mellow. And that's good. I'm loud. He's mellow. And, you know, throughout the years, and I hate to bring, like, you know, go down. And just so everybody knows, it goes down and then it goes up. So all his life, I could say that, you know, he got hit by a car when he was, like, 12. Walking with his friends on Clark Avenue. Don't know how that happened. Then, you know, we all know what happened on Easter. We're not going to bring it up, but, you know, Easter was not a fun time. Brian, where you at? Yeah, there's this boy. Easter was a fun time, and I didn't even live in the state, and I was there. But, you know, listen, I got to say, no matter, shut up, listen. Shh. Too many fucking drinks. But I'll tell you like this, no matter what, through his downs, his ups, you know, he's always been there. That's somebody I could talk to. And, like, really just listen. If it's fighting with Mom, fighting with him, fighting with the girl, like, whatever. He's always there. I could call him. Be like, Lee, this is the shit that's going on in my life. You got any words? And I kind of feel the same. When he had... You dropped your phone. When he had things going on in his life, I would get a phone call at, like, I don't know, 11 o'clock at night. Dan, listen, you know, such and such, whatever. And I try to give him the best advice I can. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, come get me, huh? I'm about to get arrested. But with that all being said, he found the love of his life. He did. And Melissa... And my Orientale family. Who would have thought after, I don't know, how many years have we been going to school together, guys? But since we were like in fifth grade, sixth grade. Who would have thought that these two would have winded up together? Never in a million years I would have ever thought. We all hung out, sing, doing kickstands and shit. But I heard a good story, you know.
how they met. So, you know, a Friday's leave, I got a hard day of work. Let me go get a massage. So we'd go get a massage from Sam. Where's Sam? Sam, where are you? There she is, Sam. Shit, I gotta hit her up tonight. He would go get the massage. And I'm gonna tell everybody right now, fucking weed's legal. So then after we would all smoke. And then Melissa would cook. What a nice life. Get a massage, then get a dinner. And this happened for a couple of weeks. And then he said in his head, you know what? I think I'm gonna ask her out. I'm single, she's single. Why not? You never know. So he grew a couple of pair and he asked her. And you know what? Look where we are today. You know, together they're married. And Melissa, I'm gonna tell you this. I think you have been one of the, if not the best thing in his life. Honestly, I feel like you keep him calm. He goes to you when I guess, you know, he don't come to me no more, he goes to you. He's your problem. But he's happy. And that's what I want. I want him to be happy. And I want you to be happy. By the way, I only heard that story about 10 minutes ago. But overall, I want to say God bless. You guys are amazing together. Everybody, raise your drinks. From my side of the family, L'chaim. From their side of the family, ching ching. Congratulations to Melissa Lee. Salud.
Totally unscripted. All right, where's Erica?
Hi, everybody. How are we doing tonight? Are we all having fun? If anyone doesn't know who I am, I'm Melissa's sister, Erica. Okay. I am the proud big sister. So just like Dan, I didn't write anything down. But I just have to say that there hasn't been a moment in Melissa's life that I haven't been proud of. I feel like I have watched her grow up my whole life, obviously as her big sister, and have just had so many happy moments with her through dancing school and through sing and cheerleading and college. Where's her college friends at? Best college experience ever. You have made me so proud to be your sister, and I love you so much. It took her a while to love me back, but we're here, and you're my best friend, and I wouldn't trust anyone in the world more than I do you with my secrets, my children. I know. They love you so much. You're the best aunt in the whole world, and I just want to say that Melissa has always been a very particular kind of person. Growing up, for me, she was a mess. Apparently, to everyone else, she's very clean. And, you know, and she's always had like a particular style and a particular kind of just way about her. And I've always worried that someone would come in and try to change her. And when Flip texted me saying that she wanted to set Melissa and Lee up, I was like, what? I couldn't think of something more perfect. Lee, I have known his, you know, for a very long time. And in high school, Lee would randomly grab rides from us in the car. We would stop at a light, and Lee would just jump in the car at the bottom of Snake Hill. I'm not a bus driver, and you still got in the car. So I couldn't think of anyone more perfect, honestly. And the more I saw them together, the more I knew she found the perfect person to make her complete, because he just accepts her for exactly who she is and vice versa. And That's honestly been my biggest concern for her in life, was that I just didn't want someone to change who she was. Honestly, because she's so funny and she's so just, we're complete opposites, by the way. But she, and she found it in Lee. And honestly, I have seen her in a tizzy and he just smiles at her and nods his head. And then goes and fixes the problem, and if everything is okay. He doesn't. So, he already has the key to marriage. He already knows. He already knows what to do. So, and honestly, you guys both complete each other, and calm each other, and get hype with each other. And I just want to say, Lee, thank you so much for bringing your family into our lives, because honestly, Iris and Andy, and obviously Danny and Danielle, are the best, and we genuinely cannot wait to learn more about Hanukkah and get invited to dinner. And Liam's very excited this year, by the way. He is very excited about Hanukkah dinner. I love you so much, and we are so happy to have you both in our lives, and I just want to say congratulations. Now let's turn the fuck up, guys. Woo!
All right, give it up for Eric.
Steve with his yarmulke. Yeah, boy.
All right. Nice job, Danielle and Erica. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll give you guys a few minutes to finish up eating. And then, just like the maid of honor said, we are going to turn the you-know-what up. Enjoy the rest of your dinner, ladies and gentlemen.
Somebody scream! Ladies, where you at, ladies? This one's for you. Just like an old-time movie. By the wishing well. Yeah. In a castle dark. Say what? Or a fortress and I won't change my mind. Just what? Melissa, you got it, girl.
Tomorrow
hearts in the air. We gotta show the bride and groom all the love we got for them.
drink tonight. Craziness up in here.
And Easy, easy.